clues in the case of human remains discovered in a Milwaukee sewer. The medical examiner is asking for help now, identifying the victim nearly 3 months later. New at 6, WISN 12 News' Colleen Henry joins us. And Colleen, investigators now know it was a black male between the ages of 20 and 60.
Yeah, Craig, the challenge for investigators, they found only parts of that victim's body. His entire torso remains missing.
It was May 30th. The city crew cleaning out sewers made the discovery, body parts floating in the water below the grate. 3 months later, neighbors here are still waiting to know who came to such an end in their alley.
I wanted to make sure it wasn't Alexis Patterson. Every time I hear a body, she's the first person that comes to my mind.
Aisha Eason says she's been checking missing people websites all summer, hoping for an ID.
You never know how many missing people out here until you look. Online.
We think most likely this individual would have gone missing between early and mid-May.
The medical examiner is now asking for the public's help. Neither the victim's fingerprints nor his DNA have turned up in public databases, and investigators still don't know how he died. But they did find a significant clue. The man had neck problems, a metal plate fusing his neck bones.
There was definitely surgery to stabilize those vertebrae in metallic hardware. Was implanted.
Investigators searched other sewers in hopes of finding the victim's torso and the clues it might offer.
More identifiable hardware, such as like a pacemaker with a serial number, a tattoo, etc., are very characteristic physical features might provide us with a better means of identification.
Aisha Eason is hoping for an answer to her neighborhood's solemn mystery.
I wouldn't know what I'd do if I had a missing loved one out there and I, you know, not knowing where that person was. So I know their family not knowing what to do.
Now, the medical examiner asks anyone with information to contact Milwaukee police. The ME has also posted details on this and other identified bodies on its website. You can find the link on our website, WISN.com. In the newsroom, Colleen Henry, WISN 12 News.
All right, Colleen, thanks.